There, I got the sky cam going. This is battery box repair. Another one of these pieces of shit, and I'm going to talk about why we hate these, why I hate these, and what you can do to not kick yourself in the ass when you break this, because most of the time it gets busted. The reason these fail is because where the battery jams down in there, right? So just understand what the hell. Not to mention it's just stupid. When the battery jams down in there, you can actually probably see how those flex, and it's just little plastic stupid extrusions that hold those. So what happens is, over time, the battery gets jammed in, these break, the contacts move, and the battery doesn't make contact anymore, and you're gouged. Okay, so I'm gonna pause and then think about a thought. Those aren't balls. That's is different than the other one. It is a different. Okay, so the way this silly thing works. Oh, back to whatever you do not use, if you're replacing this from an existing guitar, do not use the screws that Stumac gives you. Save your original screws, because the ones that are in there, actually, I lost one, but I have these. They're like really, really not anywhere near as long as the stuff that Stumac gave me, and those would have went right through the front of the guitar. Anyway, the way this works is, when the battery's in it, these little ears on the side don't compress, so that keeps it from popping in and out. So to place this back in, we're just gonna compress those, and hopefully this son of a bitch will kick in there. Come on, cooperate with me. Well, I might have it bass ackwards. Could it be true? No, it can only go this way, because that thing's there, and that's where that goes. I've been down this road before. Eventually it'll find its holes. Come on. I can't believe this. Stand by while I smash my head against the wall. Okay, yeah, we're all together there. Look, she's working just like a piece of shit. The other reason we hate these, I've seen this, oh, at least 6 times. Does that seem like it wants to close properly? It doesn't necessarily close very well. And then a little hair from your shirt, a little thread off your favorite stage shirt gets caught on that, and when you're dancing around, yanks it open for you and destroys it. And see, I still don't like the way that fits. Is it locking in place? No, not really. It's like it's just like a total piece of shit. Yeah, baby. just for fun, one more time, we're gonna go through this little piezo anomaly. So the only thing that's operating right now is the piezo. If I unplug and then I plug back in, there'll be nothing for 2 seconds. Did you guys catch that? Out. And both of them are like that. So we may have been down old Goat Street there, folks, with that other repair. I hate to say it. Maybe everyone was fooled by the technology. I don't think so. I was in there testing that and fooling around with it and was sure that I could make it fail by wiggling the jack. But once it's in and it's up, you can do whatever you want. So like I said, if you were in this mode, a little bit of stuff on there, and you plugged in, now, you know, that's these pickups working. So obviously it's had a chance to switch its thing. Always working, but if I do that, now, it comes on magically. That's the way they work. I'm sure it's in a book somewhere. We're just too stupid to read the book. Okay, cheers. Battery box. Oh, the last tip with the battery box. If you got one of these and you're playing, my advice is take just a piece of tape and put it over top that so you don't catch the box. It doesn't hurt nothing. You'll be really happy that you did that because you won't catch it on your shirt. And what was the other little trick? Don't jam the, you know, when you replace the battery, just drop it in gently. You don't have to push. I think that's what happens. People think that it, that are under the impression it might click in like this or something. I don't know. They just seem to get wrecked all the time. And be cautious of the polarity. It's really easy to mix it up on these two. So the other thing I like to do, or I used to do with mine, is if I can find the right device, I used to take something and mark. Now the plus is much more visible. Look at that. You know, geez, how tough was that, guys? You know, Mr. Manufacturing frickin' genius. Okay, done deal. Cheers. Peace, love. And shout out and thanks to any and all new subscribers, and also to all my faithful subscribers who keep coming back. I don't know why. You must be as nuts as I am. Cheers. I can see why they didn't sell many of that t-shirt, for many reasons.